2019. My name is Stephen, and today I'm going to give a short presentation on our Great Hall. Now, first of all, so a quick show of hands, who can see a stingray? Who can spot a stingray in there? There we go. That's a bit of a trick question, so be a bit mean there. There are no stingrays in this pool. There isn't a single stingray here, not one. So these guys are all called skate. There's a species of ray, or a type of ray called skate. So around the world, you get three different types of ray. You get skate, you get stingray, and you get electric ray. There's three species of skate in here. So if you guys can see a ray, it's quite pale with black dots on it. So there's one just down here, that's it, quite pale with black dots. The one down there as well, there we go, spot on. That's a small eye, that's the one, yeah, just there as well. Small eye or a blonde ray. So a small eye or a blonde ray. We've got another species called a thornback ray. So if you guys can spot a ray, it looks like it has a row of thorns along its tail. That's a thornback ray. So we see the spot where it's a bit darker than a blonde ray. That's also a painted ray. We've got a thornback ray, it's possibly just over there. That's a thornback ray, just over that way. And this is the painted ray, so we've been passing it out. Basically, the painted ray is like a splash of paint. Right, a splash of white paint. There we go, it's one just in here. So you've got the painted ray, you've got the thorn ray, you've got the thornback ray. Everything we see here is all residents of the UK. So everything that you find here is all from the UK. So when we first opened in 1996, everything was British. Everything that we housed here was British. But slowly, as we developed, we got more and more tropical creatures. And it now means that only this tank and the rock pool that you may have seen earlier are actually from the UK. And these guys here, these are all British species native to the British coastline. So another thing people ask me, are these manta rays? So there's no manta rays in here, there's no manta rays in sea life centres. So if we were to have a large manta ray here, they'd quite possibly go from that side over there, all the way from there. So a wingspan going across the entire pool that we have. So obviously we don't have any manta rays here in the sea life centre. They're far too big. So we've just got the ray. So you will see stingrays later on. So once you pass past the Amazon area, you might be able to see some stingrays. You've got some species up there. So we've got the stingrays just at the top. Right, then we're doing some feeding now. We'll throw some food in there. Right, so what will happen here? Watch your splash, guys. All of the round fish, so that's the species of fish that aren't sharks and they aren't rays, they'll probably get to the food first. So what happens later on in the day, one of our aquarists will come along with a big stick. He'll put a fish onto the end of the stick and he'll feed the sharks and the rays individually. So the sharks and the rays, we can get an individual feed. But what happens is our aquarists on our displays team keep a close eye on what shark and what ray is what's about to move. So we record it as they do it. Say, the one ray's got three fish each. The thornback's got two fish each. We'll keep a close eye for our nets. So it's very important that we keep a very close eye on what our sharks and our rays get fed. So who has seen our sharks? Anyone spot the sharks that we've got in here? Whereabouts are we? Is anyone spying on that? Can you find me a shark? No. Is there one over there, apparently? Oh, it's not just here, of course. It's not just underneath my feet, it's down here. So we actually have two species of shark in this tank. We have the lesser spotted dogfish, and we have the greater spotted dogfish. We've got two species. So sharks and rays, very closely related. your senses. So as me and you, we have five senses. The shark and the ray has two extra. So the first one, the fish has as well, it's called the lateral eye. Now this can detect changes in pressure. And the second one is the ampullae. The ampullae is the second extra sense.